It's your Commodore, Ty Coles here, with a review of Batwoman, Season 1, Episode 2, The Rabbit Hole. So we have a brief recap of the previous episode, and then we get some really cool, a very interesting action scene at the very beginning. And it felt like a true Batman. Epic. Dark alley. Bad guys running. And I liked that a lot. It was really cool. Well shot. CGI looked like crap. But the feel was there, the atmosphere, everything was there. So we go into the show. Kate believes Alice is Beth.
Seriously, Kate, you can't be going out in Gotham every night pretending to be Batman.
I need to find her. Alice is my sister, I need to know.
And now she's trying to convince everyone else. Her father doesn't want to hear it.
Listen.
She has a vendetta against you. Why? Why not kill me when she had the chance? And why does she seem to know everything about me?
I know that you want to believe that Beth is alive. I do too, but facts are facts. Beth's dead.
Because he doesn't want to believe that his daughter has become the psychotic killer that wants to destroy Gotham. Unfortunately, that could be true because... look at Star Wars, perfect example of a good person can turn evil. And I like the little banter at the dinner table.
Because of Sophie? Oh my god, can we talk about the fact that she's married to a man? Let's not. I'm not trying to label her or anything, but what's her deal exactly? She's married. Honey, drop it. Yeah, I get that, but she could still be bi, vicarious, pan, poly.
Her stepsister kind of went a little overboard about saying that her former lover now married a man. And she didn't enjoy that, how they were talking about it. And she continued. The mother's on the phone, doing her business stuff. Typical family of today. So, Kate goes out trying to prove that Beth is Alice. Alice is Beth. Well, that is original.
What the? That's it. That's it. Einhorn is Finkel. Finkel is Einhorn!
And she has the knife saying, I want to DNA test it to prove it. Despite them having DNA testing to prove that her skull fragments found 15 years ago were Beth's.
I thought they found her body.
They found bone fragments.
Skull fragments matching Beth's DNA.
I was able to get one of Alice's knives. It has a garnet stone, our birthstone. Can test the knife for DNA.
This is where I kind of question what they're trying to get here. Because, like, it's hard to get DNA off of a bone. I feel like they might have just found bone that was related to her somehow. Or I think that bone is going to be something else in a future episode. But remember those bones, because I feel like that is... because they kept on bringing the bones up in this episode, and I think it's going to play a larger part in future episodes. So, again, this episode was brought down by the acting of Alice. She, like, this is a complete Harley Quinn ripoff, and not even a good one. She's trying to act psychotic, but it just falls flat. There's no passion in her. It's like, oh, I'm crazy, but I don't see the craziness. I just see a kid having a temper tantrum that my daddy left me type, and not like a true crazy person. And so she's held up at her former house.
I think it's time for Gotham to watch Commander Crow.
We have Crow's headquarters being attacked. The one guy that Kate injured as Batwoman found her way to the underground hospital that her stepsister's running. Her stepsister's kind of in awe. That's, oh my god, this is a Batman victim. And takes the Batarang and puts it in her pocket.
He's a Batman victim. I'm so keeping this, FYI.
He's one of Alice's guys.
Kate frees the hostage and tells them to go back to Alice with a message, waffles.
Marcia, that's a good idea considering he's a domestic terrorist.
I need you to send a message to Alice from Kate Kane. Waffles. Get out of here.
We learned that Alice kills the people that she was holding hostage at her former residence.
Oh, my God!
When Alice and Kate are together, we learn some more details about the crash.
Did you survive the crash?
Crash.
Oh, yes. The crash. Let's see. We hit the water with a dramatic splash. When I opened my eyes, my mother's head was on the other side of the room.
Cool. And, you know, if you ever had, like, a younger sister or brother or anything, like, you had a sibling, you always had these secret words and stuff. So I find that real realistic that they would have something for just those two would know. The Crows are dead set on killing Alice. They got the green light from Gotham City Police. They're going after her boyfriend, who was a member of the Crows. The Crows track her down, but Kate stops it.
Get out of the way.
She's your daughter. And if you kill her, you won't just lose Beth, you lose me too.
Oh, and when they sent one of the main guys, I think it was her second, the former Crow guy, to go kill the stepsister, all you were missing was a, here's Johnny.
Here's Johnny.
So it looks like it's all over with Alice. She's going to Gotham. No, bomb blows up.
The prison transport to Arkham.
And she's saved by Kate as Batwoman. They big blow up via a bullet hitting the... That is complete garbage, man. That was bad. We had many flashbacks in the episode. And I enjoyed the flashbacks because it gave us so much more in-depth information. Like, Kate blames herself.
You weren't there, Dad. After we crashed, Beth went to check on Mom in the front seat. Instead of helping, I climbed out.
She was trying her damnedest to find her sister. And so forth and so forth. Like, she would not give up on her sister. At the end, you see that her stepmother might be the one that's trying to keep those two apart, because her stepmother gave another guy the knife to test and said to melt it down, get rid of it.
Get rid of it.
It'll be melted into a paper white.
Destroy the masks while you're at it. I'll take care of whatever surveillance was in the garage.
Which is odd. So I think she's part of the Alice cover-up, and she has something more devious in her head. I just know it. You see a little more bickering between the two stepsisters, and it's interesting to see where they're going to take this, because they're going down one certain path. They're not, like, it's very getting very predictable of what they're trying to do now. But on the other hand, they have done a decent job of telling the story. The acting might not be 100% there, But remember, people, this is only the second episode of the first season. It takes time for people to get into the character, to develop a character. It might be a slow grind. Like, look at Star Trek The Next Generation. Look at some of the other Star Treks, like Deep Space Nine and Enterprise. It took them almost to like a couple of seasons to get into their stride. Like Star Trek Next Generation didn't get into good, like its stride until season 3. Enterprise didn't get into its stride until season 3, season 4. So it might take some time. So I know people are going to say, this is woke, blah, 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 and they're crucifying Batwoman. I just don't see it, personally. There were very bad parts of this episode. Alice, I just still don't believe her as a villain. I think she's just a teenager throwing a hissy fit that her daddy left. It's a girl that has daddy problems. That's what I see. I don't see a crazed villain. And so far, you really haven't seen her kill anyone. It's always been her henchmen that have done the dirty work. And there were CGI effects in here that were god-awful. Like, god-awful CGI effects. Especially at the end with that bat flying away. But overall, a decent second episode. So Batwoman might have some of its flaws, but at least it's not Star Trek Discovery bad. But that's my review of this episode. It's a mixed bag. The cinematography, I enjoyed the atmosphere of it. Was amazing. It felt Batman-ish. There were some scenes that visually they were too dark. Like, not the subject topic or what they were doing on the show. It just looked a little too dark. I think they went on some points. But it showed the grit of a Batman movie. I feel like if they can tweak some things, Batwoman will be a decent show. But for now, I just think it's a mixed bag. So for your Commodore Tycoles, live long and prosper. Hailing frequencies are closed. Thank you for watching Commodore Ty and enjoying this video. I hope you hit the like button, subscribe to the channel, and if while you're here, check out one of my other videos. Live long and prosper. Hailing frequencies are closed.